What then is the level of equilibrium, Mr. Rajwade? We are seeing capital outflows continuing both in the debt market and in equity markets. Do you therefore see the rupee finding its place sometime in the near future, maybe at 63? What is the number that you are looking at?
Well, I think let me answer that question in two different parts. Number one is that as far as the debt funds are concerned, they were coming here on the basis of arbitrage. Arbitrage between dollar interest rates, forward margin, and the yields on short-term securities or CDs or wherever they were investing. Now, that arbitrage has practically come to zero. The forward margin has gone up. The arbitrage no longer exists, and that's why they are quitting. As far as the second part of your question is concerned, I think we have a very, not we, I think our policymakers have a very tough choice to make. In my own view, a reasonable value in terms of the competitiveness of the domestic economy is going to be somewhere around 70. Now, what that also, the corollary of that is much higher inflation, and if they don't want that inflation, then they would need to take drastic monetary and fiscal austerity measures. But I think this is a package which I do not see that a government which is facing election in less than 12 months will take the kind of bitter medicine that is probably needed. And I, my own feeling is that FIIs are unlikely to be very enthusiastic, even if the rupee has come 260. I think that the prospects in terms of growth and governance and the regulatory issues, etc., are not looking very promising at all from the perspective of a foreign investor.